Getting close to that time of the year, so Target is calling it. The chain is closing its stores at midnight on Thanksgiving Eve and reopening 6 o'clock Friday morning. Many more have already made this decision, so it begs the question, is Black Friday fading to black?
We sent Adrian Broaddus to find out, but first we also want to know, how do you do your holiday shopping? Weigh in at care11.com/vote now.
New year, same headline. Is Black Friday dying?
We keep saying this every year. It is true that if you take a 20, 25-year look at the picture, the seasonality of retailing has evened out a little bit. It used to be much more heavily concentrated in the fourth quarter. It's a little less concentrated now. That said, there's still a very important holiday season for most retailers.
Professor George John with the University of Minnesota's Carlson School of Management says this is an important holiday season for most retailers.
This is really the first year everybody's optimistic. The consensus estimate is we're going to likely see retail sales grow about 3 to 3.5%.
Monday, Target announced early access shopping for its credit card holders. Those members will get to see Black Friday deals on November 22nd. Target also revealed its Thanksgiving store hours, opening at 6 p.m. that Thursday, but closing stores at midnight. It will reopen at 6 a.m. on Black Friday. So, is Black Friday really dying?
I would say it's fraying around the edges, but the spirit of Black Friday is not dying. Just let's remember that. What is Black Friday? It's the start of that frenzied season where you're looking for deals, and the deals are going to be as common as they were before, and they're going to be sharply targeted. You got to go look for it.
According to NBC, a holiday shopping survey by the National Retail Federation shows more consumers planning to do most of their shopping this year on the internet.
If you're a retailer, it's absolutely essential you get store traffic. How are you going to get store traffic? You have to create excitement. How do you get excitement? You get everybody focused on something. A time, a place, an event. That's how you create retail excitement.
There you have it.
I get to lean to the screen and tell you how you voted.
So where do you do the majority of your holiday shopping? And it's a mix of both by a nose.
Right.
Obviously.
I'm glad that we can, you know, see both sides on the shopping issue.
How do you shop though? I don't know. Do you shop online or do you go in store?
Almost always online, because I was just talking to one of our Twitter friends right now. She wouldn't tell me where I get my clothes. So most of my stuff is like men's clothing, but they made it smaller back in the day. So I get most of it online or at thrift stores.
Right on.
But yeah, I do all of my, so my family lives out of town, so holiday shopping for their gifts is all online because it ships to them and I don't have to take it.
So the point is, like, do you go for the cheap price or do you like the experience?
I have an amendment to that, however. Most of our local retailers, you can shop online. And I'll always go, like, if I'm getting books, I'm going to Majors and Quinn or to the bookstore in Excelsior, whose name I can't remember. I can get all that online too.
Right on. Cool.
Yeah.
All right. Well, with that.
Online?
I do mix of both.
Mix of both. All right. Cool. We'll see you in about 3 minutes.
Cool.
Maybe less. Maybe more.